understand the meaning of power, observe this short video. In the first trial, the athlete lifts the barbell slowly. In the second trial, he lifts the barbell quickly. In both cases, the athlete exerts a force and lifts the barbell to the same height. Therefore, the force of the athlete performs the same work but during different times. Power is the time rate of energy transfer or the time rate of doing work. Then in both cases, work done is the same, whereas the power is different. The power of the force is greater in the second case because work is done in a shorter time.
The average power is the energy over the change in time or the work over the change in time. In SI units, the power is expressed in watt. The SI unit of the work is joule and that of the time is second. Then 1 watt equals 1 joule per second. Now consider this blender and this blender. The power of the first one is 800 watts and the power of the second one is 1600 watts. Remember, in the previous slide, we said that the power is the rate of energy transfer. Then the power of each blender represents how fast it consumes electrical energy. Therefore, the first one consumes 800 joules in 1 second, and the second one consumes 1600 joules in 1 second, which means that the second blender consumes energy faster because it has the greater power. Today, we commonly use the metric or the mechanical horsepower, where 1 horsepower equals 735.5 watts, and the empirical horsepower, where 1 horsepower equals 746 watts.
Consider an object under the action of a constant force F. If the point of application of this force is displaced from A to B between two instances T1 and T2, then the work done by F is given by F dot AB. But AB equals the displacement vector between T1 and T2. And the average mechanical power is given by the work over the change in time. Replace the work by F dot delta R, and then the average mechanical power is given by F dot delta R over delta T. But delta R over delta T represents the average velocity between T1 and T2. Therefore, the average mechanical power between T1 and T2 is given by the force dot the average velocity.
The instantaneous mechanical power is the limit of the average power as delta T approaches zero. In the previous slide, we obtained the expression of the average power. Then let's replace P average by F dot V average. You will get this equation. The average velocity vector approaches the instantaneous velocity vector as delta T approaches zero. Then the instantaneous mechanical power, or simply the mechanical power, is the dot product of the force vector and the instantaneous velocity vector.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's solve an application. Maria is pulling a loaded sled up an incline by means of a rope, which makes an angle of 30 degrees with the incline. The incline makes an angle of 37 degrees with the horizontal. The resultant friction force which resists the motion of the sled has a magnitude of 80 newtons. The loaded sled is considered as a particle of mass 30 kilograms. The magnitude of the tension force exerted by the rope on the sled equals 227 newtons. Number 1. Calculate the work done by the friction, the weight and the tension force exerted on the sled as the sled moves 2 meters on the inclined plane. Let's start by calculating the work done by the friction. The work done by the friction is given by F dot AB. Look at the figure. The direction of the friction force is opposite to the displacement vector AB. So F dot AB equals the magnitude of the friction times the distance AB times cosine 180 degrees, plugging in the numbers, so the work done by their friction equals minus 16 joules.
Now we are going to calculate the work done by the weight of the sled. This work is given by this expression, mg into h initial minus h final. The sled travels a distance of 2 meters along the inclined plane, which makes an angle of 37 degrees with the horizontal. Now, this is the initial height of the sled, and this is the final height of the sled. Then, this distance represents h final minus h initial. Consider this right-angled triangle. Sine 37 equals h final minus h initial over d. Then h final minus h initial equals d sine 37. Now we want h initial minus h final. So let's replace h initial minus h final by minus d sine 37. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the work done by the weight of the sled. It is minus 354 joules. Let's move to the work done by the tension force exerted by the rope. Look at the figure. This is the tension force, and this is the displacement vector of the sled. The angle between these two vectors is 30 degrees. Then, the work done by the tension force equals T times D times cosine 30 degrees. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the work done by the tension force, which is 393 joules.
Number 2. It takes the sled 3.16 seconds to attain a speed of 1.26 meters per second after traveling 2 meters up the inclined plane. 2.1. Calculate the average power of the weight of the loaded sled and the friction force during the time interval 0, 3.16 seconds. The average power is given by the work over the change in time. Let's start with the average power of the friction. P average is given by the work done by the friction over delta T. Replace each physical quantity by its value, then the average power of the friction equals minus 5.06 watts. Now, let's calculate the average power of the weight. This power is given by the work done by the weight over delta T. Replace each physical quantity by its value, so the average power of the weight equals minus 112 watts.
Let's move to part 2.2. Calculate the instantaneous power of the tension force and the friction force at time 3.16 seconds. The instantaneous power is the dot product of the force and the velocity vector. Let's start with the tension force. The instantaneous power of the tension force is the dot product of the tension force and the velocity vector. Look at the figure. This is the velocity vector of the sled, and this is the tension force exerted by the rope on the sled. The angle between these two vectors is 30 degrees. Then, this is going to be T times V times cosine 30 degrees. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the instantaneous power of the tension force, which is 248 watts. Let's move to the friction force. The instantaneous power of the friction force is the dot product of the friction force and the velocity vector. Look at the figure. This is the friction force exerted on the sled. What is the angle between the friction force and the velocity vector? They have opposite directions. Then the angle between them is 180 degrees. Then this is going to be F times V times cosine 180 degrees. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the instantaneous power of the friction force, which is minus 10.1 watts.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.